When you first receive the Swood editor, you will need to add the license for it to the Solid Solutions licensing app. Do this by browsing to your DAT folder, where you will find the Solid Solutions licensing installer. Run the installer to set up the licensing app. Once installed, you will need to activate the license in the licensing app. Search Solid Solutions Licensing in Windows, then follow the steps on screen to activate the license. Simply click Add License, then input your serial key into the window on screen and click Add. You will now find that your license for the Swood editor is active. If you need to deactivate your license, click to view your license and click Return. Your license is now active and the Swood Editor application is ready to be installed. Run the Swood Editor setup application, which you will have downloaded. This will set up the application ready for use. You will find that the application will be automatically opened like so. You are first presented with the main page. This page shows you which data directory you are referencing in the app. You can change the reference directory by dragging and dropping a DAT folder into the window on screen. You can update the report in the reference directory by clicking Reset Report. The update will use the report embedded into the Swood Editor tool. To ensure the embedded report is up to date, you can click Update Core Files. Next, you will find the main report page further down the menu on the left. In here, you can update information such as the report output location by using the coding on screen. By default, mine is outputting the report to the reports folder in my C drive and is using the file name as the report name, just like demonstrated. To set the output location to be the same as the project, use the code SW directory. If you follow this with report, for example, it will create a folder called report alongside your project. The next page in the menu is the design page, where you can change the naming convention of your Swood files between part then assembly or assembly then part. You can also activate the copier tools. I will now demonstrate changing the naming convention and then demonstrate the copier tool. Frame copier tool is now active. This means that when a frame is inserted into a layout, a dialog box appears where you can edit the name of your files by changing the name of the frame. This can be applied to panels and Swood boxes as well. There are only two options, the default post processor and the auto drilling option. Images section, there is a page for panel images and a page for program images. There is a variety of different options that you can toggle to customize the images in your report. In the Tables menus, you can customize your panels, stocks, and hardware tables by adding extra columns and editing the sorting order like shown. You can delete columns, add columns using the Add Column button, and then select what you would like that column to reference by using the Property drop-down list. Once you've selected the property, you can give the column a name, like so, and you can toggle things like the width of the column. You can change how the text is aligned inside of the column, and you can reorder it using the 3-bar symbol on the left. You can decide what you want to print from the report. Do this by ticking on or off if you would like the page to be shown, and you can set quantities for each set of the pages as well. Once you have made the changes to your settings, you can use the main page to reset any unsaved changes using the Reload DAC button, or, as recommended by us, create a backup of your settings using the Create Backup button. You will find the backup in the DAT Backups menu. If you would like to browse to your DAT folder that you are referencing, you can also find a button on the main page, Open Folder. This will open the DAT folder that you are referencing in File Explorer. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions regarding the Swood Editor tool, feel free to contact the Swood team on support by using the email or phone number on screen.